Time since I've prepared a video for the Ubiquity role-playing system, hasn't it? And the reason for that is pretty simple. I mean, apart from the reason that there haven't been as many different Ubiquity products to be released in the last few years, the majority of them have come from AAA games. And while I don't have a firm rule about reviewing or doing overviews of books that I've worked on, I definitely find it hard to do so. And so that's why over the years that I've been editing for Triple Ace, I've had less and less to say about the books that the company has published. My name is in the credits too, so it doesn't seem right. This time, however, I have to set my discomfort aside because the product I want to talk about in this video frankly deserves a lot more attention than it has gotten and praise. And not only that, this product that I want to talk about is also a farewell to one of the greats. So, what product am I talking about? I think you can already see from the video itself, certainly from its title. We're talking about Mordavia, Land of Horror. Now, some of you have been around Ubiquity for a while, and you might think, don't we already have a book with that title? And it's possible that you missed the Kickstarter last year. Mordavia, Land of Horror was successfully revised and expanded and delivered this year in hardcover. What is it? Well, it's 212 small font pages. Those last two are a pretty cool character sheet, which increases the original 64-page supplement considerably, and also contains two keyed color maps, two pages in size. One of the country, Mordavia, and one of its capital city. The people that I talk to, Wiggy himself, considers Mordavia to be his magnum opus. And the book opens with Wiggy's farewell to his 27-year career as one of the RPG industry's more prolific, quick, and talented writers. With more than 300 titles behind him that strongly impacted players of Savage Worlds and Ubiquity, and with writing for games for Eden Studios, Atlas Games, and Kenzer and Company, it's both a shock and a tremendous sense of loss to me and uncounted others that there will be no more new material from Wiggy. Though, hopefully, I can keep goading him into tweaking, revising, expanding, and updating older classics. Maybe we can be successful in that with your help. Anyway, the book, then, leaving the farewell behind, moves through six pages of wickedly useful history, in brief, before giving us the overview of Mordavia in Chapter 2. This is a five-page chapter which puts all of those little things in one place that you so often have to go searching for throughout a whole book or dig through appendices for. Things like, how is this nation seen by others? How does this nation view itself? What are its major travel routes? How do people get there? How do people leave? What are the costs of travel? What's the culture actually like? This important task, finished quickly and concisely and imaginatively, We move into chapter 3, which presents character creation, changes, additions, and cultural perspectives, which govern PCs and NPCs born and raised in Mordavia. While I think a lot of people will start using this book with the characters as visitors to Mordavia, the far greater than 0% chance of being eviscerated in some way while staying there makes this chapter 3 increasingly useful with each passing day and night in Mordavia. Of course, for those campaigns which start in Mordavia and feature Mordavians, the chapter is essential. Chapter 4 is The Gazetteer of Mordavia, and it runs from page 35 through to page 76. The first 31 pages cover like named regions or specific sites in the country with important locations described for each. And the last 10 pages cover other locations of note, which are sites that might not be confined to a singular location, like the South Road, or which are secret even from the locals. Chapter 5 gets into detail about the notable residents of this cursed land, with complete write-ups, alternate backstories, and alternate truths to inspire you to deepen your mysteries with layers of perception, misperception, misconception, and outright lies, while at the same time giving you tremendous freedom to use and reuse the book without repeating yourself. It's constantly refreshing the surprise. There's just so much good material in here. Wiggy's talent really shines through when he creates situations for mysteries and adventure, when he inspires horror and uncertainty, and when creating interesting, believable characters. So chapter 5 runs from page 77 to page 182, giving you 80 pages of notable characters, like we said, full write-ups, alternate write-ups, and all their statistics, plus 20 pages of notable animals, stock characters, monsters, local fauna, and local cults. Chapter 6 takes on the challenging task of improving on the work Wiggy has already done to make an iconic culture's place in the horror genre and in this horrifying country as accessible and compelling as possible. Not only as an essential ingredient of Mordavia, but also as inspiring and terrifying NPCs, or deeply satisfying characters to play. Chapter 7, the final one in the book, shows off another of Wiggy's many talents, adventure seeds. Now, in a book with inspiration for mystery, horror, betrayal, magic, and adrenalizing adventure on practically every page with text, there are 6 pages dedicated to a whole bunch of other tremendous ideas to introduce, ramp up, or return you if you've escaped or left the land of horror. Finally, as I mentioned, the icing on this creepy cake of chilling chapters, the book concludes with a bloodstained 2-page character sheet that has endeavored to leave no stone unturned. Whether you are the sort to prefer to work from suggestions and frameworks, or if you are farther down the spectrum of preparation toward preferring to work from more concrete material, this book provides detail suitable for either interest. If you work from inspiration, then Mordavia itself could inform and fuel an open-ended campaign that could run for as many years as you and your players like. If you prefer to receive support, well, Once you've made your way through all the material in this book, AAA provides you a tremendous catalog of targeted and densely packed supplements full of creation tools and prepared plots, seeds, and NPCs for a whole host of gothic and otherwise horrific monsters. Evil magicians, apparitions, mummies, shapeshifters, vampires, the fae, hags, guidance and tools to make lairs for any and all of those. And if that is not enough, there is still the untapped depths of the Cthulhu mythos. Cosmic horror, including the Dreamlands. You can draw all of this out of the dark places of Mordavia and send them hungrily after the character's sanity or flesh. And in the character's struggle against the darkness in Mordavia, they themselves might become corrupted, while the playgroup exalted. Perhaps you're worried about creating enough characters to fill a country. Well, Mordavia sends you far, far down the road of preparation in that regard. And in addition, there's also the Dramatis Personae supplement, which has over 100 prepared NPCs and what we call in the game hench people. Those who labor in the background and might just, you know, walk on, interact a little bit, and then are never seen again. Leagues of Adventure from AAA Games really packs a tremendous punch in terms of ease of use, speed of play, depth and breadth of support, and with the expansions for gothic horror and cosmic horror, it's truly hard to beat. Especially with Mordavia at the center as some telltale, undying heart. And it is with a heavy heart that I talk to you of this book today, the last new material from a great writer, Paul Wiggy Wade Williams. And I hope you'll consider checking it out. If you haven't already begun to play Leagues of Adventure, if you're unfamiliar with the Ubiquity role-playing system, well, this might be a great time to start. And coincidentally, this video will be released during October, where I hear some people like to do horror-themed games for some reason pertaining to the number 31. And I'm pretty sure it's not Baskin-Robbins that they're talking about. So where can you get it? You can go directly to AAAsGames.com and get the PDF for everything that they produce. Or, if you'd like to get print-on-demand, you can go to DriveThruRPG. Thanks for indulging me. Thanks for making it a little bit easier to get over my discomfort to talk to people who love games and gaming, and respect the people who have that special spark of talent to make the really great games. Anyway, until the next time, take care.